developments on the widespread travel disruption that affected more than 200 flights January 1st. The Civil Aviation Authority of the Philippines gave its assurances that contingency procedures are in place to avoid a repeat of New Year's Day travel mess. Aviation authorities and operations are now back to normal. The COP adds they are ready to cooperate with any investigation.
Sa ngayon po, the UPS po, balik na po sa operasyon. Dalawa po yung UPS natin. May redundancy po tayo para kung ang isa po ay bumigay or mawala ng power, meron po tayo naka-standby. Sa ngayon po, yan ay gumagana na. Kaya palagay ko po tayo ay may sufficient backup.
The agency also says they are still investigating the incident, but insists their communication, navigation, surveillance, and air traffic management system is still in good condition. Aviation officials are also continuously coordinating with airline companies to resume affected flights.
Kung ating equipment na yan, kung tawagin nga ay nasa midlife, hindi pa naman po completely obsolete. Though, we need upgrades to make sure na siya po ay makatutugon sa lahat ng pangangailangan sa ngayon. Maganda pa po ang performance niyan. Ang nangyari lang po ay nawalan tayo ng power, kaya po bumagsak ang kanyang operation. Pero nung manumbalik na po power, naibalik po natin siya sa tamang takbo po niya.
A business organization in Cebu calls on government to put up alternative airports following the travel chaos on New Year's Day. ABS-CBN correspondent Annie Perez joins us on the line for details. Annie?
Yes, that's right, Denise. A businessman in Cebu are now lobbying for an alternative airport after the technical issue encountered by the country's aviation system on New Year's Day. Charles Kenneth Koh of the Cebu Chamber of Commerce and Industry said that the incident last Sunday was a serious setback for travel and tourism, noting that it had especially happened during the peak holiday travel period. Koh backed the Department of Transportation Secretary Jaime Bautista in the upgrade of aviation equipment and to add backup power just so to ensure continuous airport operations. And Koh also highlights that the group wants more alternative airports, such as Clark, Bulacan, or even Sangli, seeing this as an improvement to the redundancy of our travel industry. As of today, there are no more stranded passengers at the Mactan Cebu International Airport per its public affairs head, Edelis Maribohok. They also have not logged canceled flights as of this time. The last two flights that were canceled were last night from Osamis and Clark coming into Cebu, but they were already rescheduled. However, they are still asking passengers to get in touch with their airlines regarding their scheduled trips today and for rebooking purposes. Meanwhile, over in Davao City, some individuals are taking on chances to get on a flight immediately as chance passengers. In their international airport, a lot of them are staying nearby, near ticketing outlets, to get a chance. They're also asking airlines to expedite their rebooking so that they can get back to their destinations, especially that work has resumed after the holiday season. Engineer Rex Obsena of the CAAP Davao said they're also monitoring developments and have also asked the same passengers to coordinate with their airlines regarding their flights and rebooking statuses. And that's the latest from Visayas and Mindanao. Annie Perez, ABS-CBN News.
Thanks, Annie.